Hello students, welcome back to a new chapter, Linear Inequations. So are you all excited for a new topic? Say yes. Yeah, it's yes only, I know. So starting with linear inequations. Before starting with the actual topic, let's understand what do we mean by linear. Kabhi bhi kisi expression ko, when we say it's a linear expression. Any expression having degree as 1 is called as linear expression. Okay, so any expression having degree as 1 is called as a linear expression. Either the expression can have 1 variable, 2 variable or 3 variable. But if degree is 1, we call it as linear expression. Okay. Now coming back to the name of the topic, linear, we understood. What is inequation? Aaj tak equation padhe the, ye inequation aa gaya. So before studying inequation, let's see our traditional equation only. Understand the concept? I am not explaining you first inequations. Pahle I am making you understand only the equation, the traditional equation which we used to study. So here is the equation. Okay, so on the screen, linear equation. Linear means degree should be 1. Okay, see here, power of x is 1. Power of y, nothing is mentioned, means by default it's 1. Okay, and here we have 2 variables. Yes, x is 1 variable and y is 1 variable. And if we see the degree of this entire expression is 1. So that's the reason it is called as linear. But now I want to explain you all why this is called as an equation. So students, listen this carefully. Whenever in any expression, this equal to sign comes. Can you see this red color circle? I have emphasized on this equal to sign. See the marker. So because of this equal to sign, we call this expression as equation. Of course, here we have 2 variables, so I can say it's a linear equation in 2 variables. Similarly, down I have an expression which also involves an equality sign, so that's the reason I will call it as equation. And if I see the power of x is 1, so this expression is linear. So to sum it up, I will say it's a linear equation in 1 variable. So students, what we studied up till now, कि अगर किसी भी expression में this equal to की sign आ जाए, तो उसको बोलते हैं equation. It is called as equation. So now let's study and let's compare. What is inequation? Inequation. Okay. So the screen in front of you. Linear inequations. The left side we already studied, students. Now just to have a comparative look, I have written something on the right hand side. Same examples. I have written here 7x plus 5y and here 3. But see the cursor. Please see the cursor. Here on the left hand side, it was equality sign. So we call it as equation. But here on the right hand side, I have something different. See the cursor. Kya bolte hai ye sign ko? Isko bolte hai greater than equal to. What we call it as greater than equal to. So here we don't have equality sign, greater than or equal to sign. Okay. Of course, degree of this expression is 1 only. X ka power is 1, y ka power is 1. So it is linear. It has 2 variables, but it is called as an inequation because yahan pe equality nahi hai. So equation nahi bolenge. Yahan pe there is some imbalance. So that's the reason we call this symbol as inequality sign. So the entire expression will be called as inequation. Similarly, students, if we come down over here, I have 1 variable. Same example I have copied. See the cursor, please. Here it was equality sign and now it is less than sign. So again, there is an imbalance. I can see here it is less than sign. And this is called as inequality sign. So that's the reason this expression is called as linear inequation. So to summarize our concept, can I say any expression which have inequality signs, either this greater than equal to or less than, or it can be less than equal to, or it can be greater, any inequality sign, then the expression is called as inequations. Okay. So now moving on to the next slide, students. So any expression using following inequalities is known as inequation. कोई भी एक्सप्रेशन में इफ यू हैव इन इक्वालिटीज सो दैट एक्सप्रेशन इज कॉल्ड एज इन इक्वेशन विच वॉट आर कॉल्ड एज इन इक्वालिटीज किसको बोलते हैं इन इक्वालिटीज लेस देन ग्रेटर देन लेस देन और इक्वल टू ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू दीज आर कॉल्ड एज इन इक्वालिटीज स्टूडेंट्स दिस चैप्टर हैज ओनली वन रूल बट अ गोल्डन रूल सो द रूल कम्स ऑन द स्क्रीन Hope you know the logic. Up till now, whatever I taught, you should have paused the video and noted down in your notebook. After my explanation also, pause your video. Rule. When each term of an inequation, now we are speaking with respect to inequation. Okay? Ab jo bhi baat hogi chapter mein, it is with respect to inequation. When each term of an inequation is multiplied or divided by same negative number, then inequality sign reverses. I like to convert this in Hindi. When each term of an inequation, jab har ek term koi inequation ka is multiplied or divided by same negative number. Matlab both the sides pe if I multiply or I divide by a negative number. तो क्या होगा द इनइक्वालिटी साइन विल रिवर्स दैट मींस लेस का ग्रेटर हो जाएगा ग्रेटर का लेस हो जाएगा एंड सो ऑन लेट्स सी एन एग्जांपल इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस एग्जांपल वन इट्स गिवन टू मी इन द क्वेश्चन दैट माइनस एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू 7 दिस इज माय क्वेश्चन नाउ सी I don't like, you also don't like minus associated with x. So I just want to send this minus here with 7. So if I send this minus here with 7, technically that step is called as multiplying both the sides by minus 1. Huh? I know that we don't do it and we don't even realize it. But technically this is the step that if I multiply minus 1 on both the sides, minus and minus here becomes plus. And here minus 1 multiplied by 7 becomes minus 7. So see here, minus x became plus x. And this minus got shifted here with 7. So it became minus 7. But can I say technically you had multiplied both the sides by minus 1? So what rule we saw here? Once again, see here, when each term of an inequation is multiplied, we have it multiplied, okay? By same negative number we did with minus 1, then inequality sign reverses. In Hindi, ulta, reverse ho jayega. So here it was greater than equal to, so yahan ho jayega less than equal to. Theek hai? Minus yahan pe aa gaya, but inequality sign reverses. So now let's look one another example of division now. Example number 2, students, minus 7x is less than equal to 21. Now I just want x here. I want the value of x. So can I say I'll just if this won't be an inequation, if this had been an equation. So aap kya karte? Aap minus 7 ko you must have sent directly down. But this is not a normal equation. So we need to follow some things here. Dividing both the sides by minus 7. Because when minus 7 will be divided on this left hand side, then only minus 7 will be cancelled. So dividing both the sides by minus 7. So minus 7x upon minus 7, 21 upon minus 7. Minus 7, minus 7 got cancelled. And 7 we know, 7 ones are 7, 3s are 21. And your minus 3 will be left. But what you did actually, you divided both the sides by minus 7. In other words, can I say according to the rule, you divided both the sides by same negative number. So inequality sign will reverse. Original question mein it was less than equal to and it got converted into greater than equal to. So x is greater than or equal to minus 3. So to summarize, when both the sides of an inequation is multiplied or divided by a same negative number, then inequality sign reverses. Great. This was the only rule I in this chapter. Moving on to a note, which you all must be knowing it, but then to recollect it, we have some concept called replacement set. Okay, we need to replace our question, so we call it as replacement set. In other words, we can also call it as domain. We can call it as domain. Okay, generally we call it as replacement set. Natural numbers. Yeah, actually I'm revising the things which you already studied in 6th or 7th standard. Natural numbers. You should know that it is all, they are always denoted by capital N. And what are natural numbers? Starting from 1 and going up to positive infinity. In maths, these three dots shows infinity. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and goes on. Starting from 1, remember this. Whole numbers. What are whole numbers? They are denoted by capital W. And the difference between natural number and whole number is just an extra zero. So starting from zero, going to positive infinity. Next comes the integers. Be careful, students. Whenever word integer comes, it can be denoted by capital I or capital Z. So you should be familiar with both the alphabets. And integer means all the numbers. Just be careful, decimal numbers will be never included in this set. All the numbers, positive, negative, including zero. So 0, 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. Means up till all positive extreme. And here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, dot, dot, dot. 2 towards negative extreme. Only decimal numbers are not there in this set. Okay, all positive, all negative integers and including zero also. And here comes some interesting case, students. We have real numbers. Real numbers kya hote hai? All numbers. To be more precise, all positive in numbers, all negative numbers. And when I say positive numbers or negative numbers, then in this integers bhi aate hai and all decimal numbers bhi aate hai. So all positive numbers, all negative numbers, all decimal numbers, all integers. Except imaginary numbers. This concept is not there in your syllabus. It is there in the 11th maths. Okay. So for your syllabus is concerned, all positive, negative integers, all positive, negative decimal numbers also. Of course, zero is also included. These are real numbers. Okay, students. So now moving up to the next slide. Okay. Students, I really want you all to please pause my video at after every note. This is the key for the chapter. I have 4 notes for you. And this is, I will say, the chapter. After completing the next 10 minutes of video, you can challenge anybody in this universe for this chapter. Believe me. But eyes on the screen. Okay, understand it carefully. I have taken an example for you, and actually I'm explaining the entire chapter. Iske baad chapter mein kuch nahi bachta hai. Just we'll be solving sums. That's it. Understand this. Note number 1. Okay. I have a range in front of me. How we pronounce it? Minus 3 is less than equal to x is less than 4. Be careful here, equal to symbol is not there. Okay. What is my replacement set? This is called as replacement set, that X belongs to capital N. This symbol means belongs to, and capital N means natural numbers. So X belongs to natural numbers. Okay. That means in this question, your X should be replaced only by natural numbers. X should be replaced only by natural numbers. Okay, so minus 3 is less than equal to x, is less than 4. So can I say yahan pe equal to ka symbol hai? That means minus 3 is somewhere equal to x. and minus 3 is also less than x. So can I say minus 3 is equal to x, even minus 2 is equal to x, even minus 1 is equal to x, even 0 is equal to x. Array, if now I start with positive 1 is also equal to x, 2 is also one of the value of x, 3 is also one of the value of x, but 4 will not be the value of x because your equal to ka symbol is not there and x is less than 4. But students, because they have given to us that x belongs to natural numbers and natural numbers starts with 1 only. So that's the reason minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0 will not be included in our solution set. So our solution set will be 1, 2, 3. Even 4 will not come because your equal to ka sign is not there. So remember, it's compulsory to write solution set. There is one mark in board exam for writing solution set. Even if you draw a number line, let me tell you one thing, in all the questions of board exam, it will be compulsorily asked to you all to draw a number line. And drawing number line is the gist of any question for this chapter. But if you forget to write the solution set, and students, I'll say 70% students forget in the excitement of drawing the number line, they forget to write the solution set, and one marks is deducted. Solution set always written in curly brackets. So you have 1, 2, 3. Okay, students. So now we have a number line. Now how to draw the number line? Students, to explain this number line, I want you all to repeat with me a small note. The note is there on the right hand side of your screen. See the students. Inclusive. Whenever you want to denote that any number is inclusive, matlab andar hai range ke, so we denote it by a darkened circle. And whenever we need to denote that any number is exclusive, wo number included nahi hai, that means wahan pe equal to ka symbol nahi hai, so we denote it by a hollow circle. Please repeat with me. Inclusive, darkened circle. Exclusive, hollow circle. Once again, अगर कोई नंबर आपकी रेंज के अंदर है, x की वैल्यू से इंक्लूसिव है, x की वैल्यू में इंक्लूसिव है, so we call it as, we denote it as darkened circle on the number line. And if any number is not equal to the value of x, we denote it as exclusive, hollow circle. I wanted to plot 1, 2, 3. So 1 here is a natural number, so it came 1, 2, 3. So 1, a darkened circle. 2, a darkened circle. 3, a darkened circle. 4 was not inclusive within our range, so that's the reason 4 did not come in the solution set as well as on the number line. Okay. And one more important, very important thing. You can see that the value of x or range of x starts from 1 and ends at 3. So if you stop your number line at 3 only, if you don't write this 4, then 1 marks will be deducted. It's a compulsion, it's a rule that we should write one extra number on number line on the right hand side as well as on the left hand side. And marking of arrowheads is compulsory. See the arrowhead here and arrowhead here, because if you don't mark arrowhead, it resembles a segment. Understanding, students? So, but this is what? This is a line. Okay. Hope you understood, students. So now moving up to the next note, note number 2. Okay, note 2 is in front of you. Will be going a little bit faster. Same thing. I have not changed the range. Minus 3 is less than equal to x and x is less than 4. But here, replacement set x belongs to whole number. Yahan pe kya hai? Whole number. So what's the difference? Whole number starts with 0. So here, of course, minus 3 is inclusive because here equal to ka sign hai, but minus 3 will not come, minus 2 will not come, minus 1 will not come, because minus 3, minus 2, minus 1 does not belong to whole number. But can I say 0 do belong to? So here the extra 0 will come. So here replacement, here after looking at the replacement set of whole numbers, 0, 1, 2, 3 are our solution set elements. Now, once again, those elements which are inclusive, that will be resembled by a darkened circle. Please repeat with me here. It's here. See this. Inclusive means darkened circle. Exclusive
zero
means hollow
circle.
Is inclusive. So zero will come. One is inclusive. One will darkened circle. Two darkened circle. Three darkened circle. Don't have a doubt that, sir, we don't have four. Why we are not drawing hollow
there
circle on four?
There can be a doubt in your mind. Sir, four is not inclusive because yahan pe equal to ka sign nahi hai.
So why we are not drawing a hollow circle on four? Answer is, whenever domain diya ho, natural numbers ka, whole numbers ka or integers ka, so we will never use hollow circle. Hollow circle ka concept is used only when the domain is of real numbers. Why so? We will see when we'll come to that note. Similarly, -3, -2, -1 does not belong to the domain of whole numbers only. So that's the reason here we have not marked anything over here. So now let's proceed to the next note, note number 3. Note number 3 is there in front of you, students. Now, let's first repeat with me. If something is inclusive, okay, here I have the note in front of you. If something is inclusive, so darkened circle. And if something is exclusive, so hollow circle. But as I told you, inclusive ka concept is darkened circle and exclusive ka hollow circle. This exclusive concept will be used only when we deal with real numbers ka concept. Jab kabhi in domain, in replacement set, natural number, whole number or integers is given, we will never use this hollow ka circle concept. So here we will not use. X belongs to integers and Z also means the integers. So now same domain, -3 is less than equal to X, X is less than 4. Here integers is mentioned and integers are positive as well as negative. So -3 is equal to X. See this line. See this equality line. So -3 will come here, -2 will come here, -1 will come here, 0 will come, 1, 2, 3 will come, 4 will not come. Why 4 will not come? Because there is not an equality sign over here. So it will stop at 3. So -3 darkened circle, -2 darkened circle and so on. Okay. And now comes the most important note, note number 4. It is very, very important, note number 4. So I request you students, please stay tuned on the screen very well. Okay. Note number 4 in front of you. -3 is less than X is less than 4. Same thing. X belongs to real number. Capital R means real number. So your replacement set is real number. Now one more thing. Students, I gave you the definition. The real number is dunya ka har number, all the number except imaginary numbers. So but solution set of a real number will never be written in the list form. ऐसा कॉमा कॉमा करके जो हम लिखते थे वो फॉर्म में नहीं लिख सकते हैं. See this should be in the set builder form only. What is set builder form? We will see down. And not in the list form. Why so? क्या रीजन है? Let me take you all to the previous note, note number 3. In note number 3, I wrote -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3 because these elements come in the solution set. But can I say, here it was integer, so these many numbers will only come. But real number ke andar decimal numbers bhi aate hai. So this -3 or -2 ke beech mein, there must be infinite numbers. -3.1, -3.01, -3.02, -3.03, -3.0001. So just between -3 and -2, there can be infinite numbers. Between -2 and -1, there can be infinite numbers and so on. So the moral of the story is listen carefully. Whenever replacement set is a real number ka set, we will not write the set in the list form. We will write in set builder form. Theek hai? Comma comma karke list form mein nahi likhenge. We will write in set builder form. How we will write? Solution set S dot S is how to write X. This slash, what, how we read this slash as is such that, we read it as is such that. So X is such that X, the symbol ka matlab belongs to. So how we read
x is such that, हमेशा you need to mark a slash like this, starting from top right to bottom left. X is such that x belongs to capital R, means a real number, then comma, and just copy this, whatever is here. Okay. And another very important case. Now, how to draw the number line? Students, you must be thinking, sir, why you have drawn this bridge here? Why we are not highlighting with the darkened circle or hollow circle? Okay, students, let me once again take you all back to my previous note. What was my previous note? It was of integers. So here I marked this minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0. Can I say in the case of real numbers, as I told you, minus 3 and minus 2 ke beech mein, there can be infinite numbers. Minus 3.1, minus 3.2, minus 3.12, minus 3.123, minus 3.1, minus 3.1234, minus 3.12345. There can be infinite numbers between these two integers also. So if you just mark the darkened circle over the tops of the integers, you are not including the middle part. See the cursor. So that's the reason. Another very, very important scenario, students. Very, very important scenario. Whenever real number ka replacement set is given, to aapne ye bridge banana hai, bridge. So up till now we have done two important cases of real numbers. First is solution set will be in the set builder form, and second, number line will be in the bridge form.
Here it bridge
was, it was given to us that minus 3 is less than or equal to x. See here, yahan pe inclusive hai. So what will happen, students? Because here we have inclusive symbol here. So what will happen? Minus 3 is inclusive of x. So here darkened circle will come. And here it is given that x is less than 4. Here equal to ka symbol nahi hai. So this 4 is not included. So because it's a real number set and 4 is not included, but can I say 3.99999 is included? Yes, 3.999999 is included, but just the 4 is not included. So the reason, so that's the reason here on 4 a hollow circle will come. This shows ki just 4 is not inclusive, but 4 ki just pehle wala 3.999999, up till that much also it is inclusive. So minus 3 ke saath I have equal to symbol, so darkened circle will come. 4 ke saath I don't have inclusive symbol, so hollow circle will come. So how will I denote? See this minus 3, a straight line I'll draw. 4, a straight line I'll draw. Theek hai, I'll draw the bridge. Minus 3 is inclusive, so a darkened circle. 4 is not inclusive, so a hollow circle. Hope you understood, students. I just wanted to share one more method which is there in many books. One method is of drawing this bridge and on the top of the bridge marking the darkened circle and hollow circles. Another method, I'm just explaining you, but we'll be continuing our entire lecture with this method only. Another method is this one. See, the note is in front of you. As I told you, another method. See the cursor. If inclusive, then draw line. So yeah, minus 3 was inclusive. So a line over here. And a semicircle when exclusive. So this type of semicircle, because 4 inclusive nahi hai, but 3 ka last digit tak inclusive hai. 3.9999 tak inclusive hai. Just 4 inclusive nahi hai. So a semicircle here and a bridge. But the problem with this method is in exam, certain times in exam, the semicircle you all don't draw it properly. And sometimes it seems to be a straight line only and you get wrong for that. So that's the reason this method is not advisable. Okay, students.